Welcome everyone, I'm Marco Zuppone, I'm a Sentinel trainer based in Camberley, UK, and in this short video I will talk you about how to create and deploy a Trialware license. First of all, what is a Trialware license? A Trialware license, even called unlocked license, is a software license that is not bound to a specific machine. Normal SL licenses are bound to the machine through the fingerprint, but not trial licenses. For this reason, the activation phase is not needed to issue the trial licenses, and it is easy to distribute them. Normally, a Trialware license is a time limited, and the ISV defines the duration terms. The trial license can be used on the same machine one time only. This is important because in this way you avoid that the end user, instead of buying the real license, continues to use the trial licenses indefinitely. The trial license enables the vendor to issue SL licenses to allow the end user to evaluate their software. If the end user decides to buy before or after the expiration of the trial license, the paid license, the vendor can issue it in HL or SL format. The particularity of the Trialware license is that it is not bound to a specific machine. No activation is required to issue it and can be used on any machine. The license terms of the Trialware license is defined by the ISV before to issue it. Normally, the Trialware license is time-based for a period between 1 to 90 days from the first execution of the protected application, but it is even possible to set a fixed expiration date. For some special usages, the vendor can create a Trialware license that never expires as well. One typical business case is when the vendor wants to protect an application with envelope to preserve their intellectual property, but they do not want to license the application binding it to a specific computer. Now let's see how to create a Trialware license. To create it, we start from the catalog tab and we create an unlocked version of the product. The next step is to go to the developer tab to issue the license. I will demonstrate this process in a bit. What kind of SL license do you obtain when you issue a trial license? Admin mode or user mode? This table shows that this depends on the configuration of the base product. As you can see, in most of the cases, you get an SL admin mode license. Only if your product is configured to allow SL user mode licenses only, your Trialware license will be an SL user mode one. There are different ways to deploy the Trialware license. The simpler one is to create a runtime environment installer bundled with the Trialware license. In this way, the Trialware license and the vendor library will be deployed automatically during the installation of the runtime environment. It's time now to see in practice how to issue and deploy a Trialware license. Let's see now how to issue a Trialware license for a product that I have already defined in my catalog. I go to the catalog tab. This is the product I'm going to use in this demonstration, Aldus MZ. The first thing that I need to do is to go to Actions and select Unlocked. I name this product variation, let's say Trial Aldus MZ. I leave these parameters as the default. Very important thing is to configure my feature to define the license terms of the trial license. I click on configure. In this case, I allow these features to run on a virtual machine because I'm in a virtual lab. And I define the number of days, let's say 10 days. So this trial will be valid 10 days after the first run of the protected application. I press save, and then I press save as complete. Now I move to the developer tab to issue this license. The first thing is I need to go here to bundle unlocked products. I select my batch code, is already selected. I press add products. I will see in this list only the trial products, and I select this one, Trial Aldus MZ, and I press OK. Now I click on this button, produce V2C. The V2C is produced now and is in the downloads folder. That's fine. Now I need to go to RTE installer. Here I have the possibility to bundle this V2C with the installer of the runtime environment. So check that your batch code is selected. Okay, it is already there. Is a Windows application I want an executable. I need to check this box, include V2C for bundle of unlocked products. I click on the three dots. I point to the file V2C that I already generated, and I press open. And now I'm ready to generate my runtime environment installer with the bundled V2C. I press then generate. Now we can move to the end user machine, install this runtime environment, and see if our protected application will work fine. I am now on the end user machine where I have my protected application and the bundled runtime environment installer. Let's go to install it now. The runtime installer has been installed. And now let's open the ACC so we find out if the runtime environment is installed correctly. And let's see what is deployed with the runtime environment. So we go to Sentinel keys. As we can see, we have already one key. It is the key that contains the Trialware license. We go to products. The products is Aldus MZ. And if I go to features, I can see that I have the feature that is part of this product is a time period, 10 days, and the days are not start. So let's try now to launch the protected application. The protected application works, as now as you can see, the time period just started and will end in this day. So this trial license will cease to work the February 23rd. This brings us to the end of this video. I hope you found it useful and interesting. Please stay tuned to our channel for further video. Thank you and bye.